Yeah, what's going on, guys? This is my first like graphic kind of tutorial and tips and stuff. Basically, today I'm working with my guy Chief Keith. This is basically just like the vector I've done so far. I illustrated like the shapes and stuff so far. That's the original picture. But basically, today I'm going to show you how to do like this kind of stubbly kind of effect. I also use it with like tattoos and stuff, so you can also use it like effectively with tattoos, which I'm going to show as well. It's probably not the best kind of way to do it, but I've only been designing for a couple of days, so this is the way I've like kind of learnt how to do it. Let me just find the layer. I've lost the layer now. Kind of unprofessional, but Chief Teeth. Nah, I don't even know what I'm done with the layer now. Wow. Dreadlocks. We'll find it. It's one of these. Right, here we go. Right, this is basically the layer I've done. Right, so basically what you do. So I've got my layer here. Let's put it under the original picture. Right, so you grab your paint tool, paintbrush tool. Zoom in a bit. Let's put it to about 12-ish. Right, now basically put on a black brush. Now give it like a little wiggle. Where it's that stubbly kind of effect is. Right. Looks like it's done by a 2-year-old, but we're gonna go with it anyway. This is hidden behind the lips anyway. Most of like the parts of this is like under vectors. So right. Right, that's done. See, it's been kind of hidden now by the lips anyway. Right, so now you're kind of left with this. Let's just touch it up a tiny little bit here. This is really, really basically done. I'll take more time doing it. But, right, so here's your layout. Basically, first step, filter, noise, add noise. Put about 14 on it. Gaussian, whatever the hell that says. Right, tap OK. Grab this tool here. Right, I've done that wrong. Start again, zoom out. Make sure you get all like the stubble you're trying to do in it. I'm still not doing it right. Right, that'll do. Right, then the next step, filter again, blur, radial blur. You want it on about 6. Blur method zoom, which I'm gonna put it on 5. Quality best, so. Go okay on that one. Then go to your like overlay settings, click hard light, go into the actual settings and just lower the opacity so it kind of goes to about there. Obviously when you're zoomed in it doesn't look that good. It does look pretty slapdash, doesn't look very good. Obviously it's not even on his chin, I've done it so rough, but just so you get the idea of how to do it. But once you zoom out, it does fit in quite good. Also, you could do it with shadowing, so obviously when you're shadowing your pictures, you're tinting it around the edges and whatnot. Under the eyes, I might do a bit, like just shadow around the nostrils, that kind of thing. But yeah, basically, that is how I'm working with Chief Keith right now. This took a couple hours so far, I'm still kind of learning Photoshop. I've only been designing for a couple of days, but yeah, just started this channel. I'm doing vectors like every day, so I just bought a MacBook. So I'm pretty into designing and stuff right now. So yeah, that's basically my little tutorial on how to do. You can also do it with tattoos, but that's basically how you do it. I'll quickly just draw something. I've lost that layer now. Let's try again. See that one? No, that one. No. 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 God's sake! I shouldn't have touched it. you know what, forget it, we're going to do a whole different layer. Right, so say he's got, I think they're lips, but yeah, let's try it. So grab your pen tool, just doing it roughly. Going for him, deleting all my anchor points. Just being so rough with it. Just so rough, right? Fill it, let's go. It's like a ready colour, so dark ready. Right, that's done. Delete that. Delete your path. Make sure you delete your path. Hard light again. Kind of turn down the opacity. Noise. Add noise. Same thing. 14. Same tool. Same effect. Blur. Radial. Didn't really do much to it. What's that done? Huh, it's weird. Hasn't really done it, but yeah. Let's try different effects. Isn't too bad. That's what I'm saying. As soon as you zoom out, that looks 10 times better. And obviously I didn't even do the infill on it, I just literally did the out bit of it. That's basically how you do it. Yeah, I'm going to be uploading lots and lots more kind of tutorials and stuff. This is just a quick one. Just want to shout out Yudi, Tommy, helping me out so far. So yeah, basically I've only been editing a few days and just picking up some tips and stuff. And that's the quickest kind of way I've learned so far on how to do shadowing and that kind of thing. But yeah, I know it's kind of long, this video. But yeah, basically, that's it. That's my tutorial. Hope you enjoyed it. Subscribe if you're not already. That kind of jazz. And peace.